Welcome to Yusuf Bake's talk show, and today we have Suzanne Coelho, a musician.
Good evening. So today we have Suzanne. Suzanne, what's up? How are you? Suzanne is a magician, by the way, and I happen to, catch her on WhatsApp once. So I just thought to probably check because she's, a nice music person. So Suzanne, what's happening?
Nothing much. Just trying to be positive in this lockdown.
So how are you? I mean, you sing. I mean, by the way, your name. Okay. So I have your name as Suzanne. Coelho, right?
Coelho, yeah.
Coelho, I'm sorry for that, okay. But by the way, because your last name reminds me of Paulo Coelho, okay, who is a writer. So
yeah, so it's basically a Goan surname.
Okay.
But Goa has its branches from Portuguese, and therefore, like, Paulo Coelho.
Okay.
So, but
you're very famous, by the way. I hope you know that. You're very famous. Book-wise.
Nowhere related to Paulo Coelho, sadly. But I wish I was related to him somehow.
Because I read two of his books, okay? I think
the
two
Alchemist?
Of his books, and that one was Alchemist, which is like widely known. And the second was the Veronica. There's this girl who tries to kill herself, but she's unable to. Nice book. But, I just understood one thing that, there's the people with your surname are very intellectual. They are highly philosophical. Maybe I'm wrong or right. I don't know, but that's what my experience is. So, Suzanne, as you are a musician, I like singing too sometimes. But, I'm usually a bathroom singer. So, like everybody. So, now coming to your profession. So, what is music to you, by the way? What appeals and what makes you, move, or what pulsates you when it comes to music? Let me know.
So as a teenager, I was introduced to music as a teenager. And initially, my parents took me for music sessions. And that's how I, kind of started loving music. But then I really think that music is one of the best ways anybody, for that matter, can express themselves, very clearly. So not just a mode of expression, but also a mode of, which makes you happy. Like I really have seen how music changes people's lives, how they not just get inspired or motivated with music, but they also have fun in music. You can dance in music. So I really think music is different for everybody, but at the end result, it's a positive one.
Okay, so, that's how you see music. So, because I think, I happened to direct a few plays where, I had to learn a lot of singing. So, you like the classical one or the Indian, or is there any genre you like the most?
Well, I do like Western classical and Indian classical. So, in the violin, I play Western classical. Yeah. In the bansuri, which is the Indian flute, I play Indian classical. But I also like world music, rock, pop, baroque music. And, I really like country pop as well. So I think that I like music in most of its forms, even if it's metal, but not too much of hard metal, but metal, I like music however it comes.
Okay, so probably I think I have heard Louis Armstrong. I have heard that Wonderful World. That's something.
Jazz player?
Yeah. 3 degrees of Green. I'm sorry, I forgot the lyrics, okay.
What a wonderful world.
I like
he was
that.
Also great. Yeah, he was also a great trumpeter. And since you like What a Wonderful World is like takes me back to childhood. I remember hearing that song a lot. I also remember there was this Vodafone ad, which used the song What a Wonderful World. And if you remember that, I was like very, very young. Many years back. Since you mentioned What a Wonderful World, I'll just improvise on What a Wonderful World.
Please, I would love to see that.
Are you able to hear me clearly?
Yeah, please. Right?
Thank you.
Great, man. Great. I for some time, okay, I thought, okay, I was listening to the Titanic song, but you know, it came back to track again. That's good.
Yeah, that's the thing about instrumental. Like, you know, you go to another song which sounds very similar and then you come back. Unless, you know, you have lyrics in it or a singer singing, it's completely different.
I agree. I'll tell you one fact about music. I feel that, okay? That you should not go and check the lyrics on Google. You should make your own lyrics.
Yeah, and then you form different words.
Seriously? So, like, that is what I feel like. True.
Yeah, that is true. Like, I've seen people, like, even what I enjoy the most is people not knowing the lyrics but making their own lyrics and singing the song.
True.
That really shows how much, you know, of interest they have. So, I mean, it's unbelievable how music can reach a person. You know, it's seriously unbelievable.
I understand. But I'll tell you one more thing, Susan. Is that just the flute or you've got more instruments and you've played? How many instruments have you mastered?
I wouldn't say I've mastered any instruments, to be honest, but I think it's a long, long way to master one instrument. But I play the keyboard, the bassuri, the violin, these three instruments. And I sing the Western vocals. So I've done my grades in Trinity, certified myself in the same so that I can teach and, you know, get better with it. So that's why. So
That's great. So here, when it comes to music, I want to ask one more question. So I came to know, the Spanish. Now, Spanish, I have seen the guitar, the Spanish guitar. Spanish guitar and the American guitar. So there are 100 different types of guitars, right?
Well, you can say that. Look, like, to be honest, like, you have the plectrum guitar, which is like the American style of playing it or the European style of playing it. And the Spanish guitar, like you mentioned, actually has nylon strings. Then you have, you know, in the guitar family, you have the mandolin, which is a little more smaller version. Then you also have the ukulele. So you have a lot of instruments in the guitar family itself. And I think like every region, every country for that has their own version of, you know, expressing the instrument of how they play it. Now, my brother plays the guitar and the keyboard. My elder brother, his name is Sobos. Yeah, so he plays a Spanish guitar. I know that, you know, it has nylon strings and the frets are a little more wider. And he has to play it with his fingers. But compared to like the normal guitar, the strings made of steel, he has to use a plectrum. So then you have the electric guitar, the bass guitar and the lead guitar, you know, which are connected to an amplifier. So I think there are a lot of instruments just in one family. The same way, like for the violin family, you have the violin, the viola, which looks a little bit bigger than the violin, the cello, which is like this big from the floor till here, and the bass, which is like huge. So you have to stand and play it.
So I think every instrument has its... There are these two brothers, right? They it's called a cello, by the way, though it's written as C-E-L-L-O. But we call it cello. And they have those big, instrument. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah. Right? Yeah.
That is a bass, actually. That's a bass. Okay. It's not the cello. The cello is like what you sit and you play with the bow. So that's cello.
Okay.
So, yeah.
That's great, man. I mean, so many instruments. I mean, I don't even know. I just have a piano here. Forget it. Okay, I'll tell you one more thing about this music, which I really drives me. Because even I should not say that, you know, I have gone through instruments and all. But, you know, sometimes it's ears. So you play by your ears. You look at people. You understand, this is what they're doing. So when you, do that 1 + 1 = 2, you understand, this is how music is created. And I think that's half of the way people learn. But there is one very, very minute thing which I happen to see. The phonetics, I'm sorry for that, I don't know how you pronounce that word. The sounds of a language and the sounds of any instrument, of that country or of that area should match. It's only then, the music really goes. Because I have seen fusion, for example. Fusion is when you put like two different genres and you run it. Am I right or wrong in that?
Yeah.
I'm just trying to ask a question.
Yeah.
So when you
two or more,
that's how it works. So let's say, for example, Tamil. Go on, yeah, sorry.
Yeah, so like for a fusion, you put two or more, genres of music together. But also, like, I think that when you're an Indian classical violinist, you automatically come to know, okay, this sounds Indian. But when you hear a Western classical violinist, you just know it, you know, it sounds Western. It doesn't sound Indian. Because many the style of playing, like Indian classical violinists, they put their violin like this, Western classical put it like this. Indian classical violinists do a lot of, they sway down a lot, you know, they slide their fingers. So the tune goes like, it slides a lot.
Oh, yes.
So that's how it shows you, like even like how we speak Hindi or Marathi or even any of the South Indian languages. That's the way we speak. It's mostly taken up from the way we talk. So I really think like when I hear a Spanish guitar, even without seeing it, you can automatically tell like, okay, this is coming from Spain.
Hola, like, hola, ¿cómo estás?
Yeah, like Zindagi Bina Milegi Dubara. Like in the beginning, only when you hear the guitar playing and you know, the percussion playing, you just know it's okay, something from Spain.
Yes, that's true. That's true.
Yeah, the music has a lot to do with the language. I'm not sure scientifically or any proof, but I've really noticed that as well, just like you mentioned. So yeah,
I agree with you 100%. I'll tell you why. It's because, you know, I have seen that when I hear the mridangram or thaval, I automatically get, you know, all the South Indian pictures in my head. From Kerala, okay, everything. Same, okay, if I hear Tutari, okay, I have a, you know, Pune in my head. So you have this Goan band, right? You guys have, right? If I'm not wrong, I'm sorry.
Like the Goan Masala song?
Yeah.
Like the Goan Masala song, which is played in all weddings, yeah. Like, also, like even when you hear the Iktari, it's just a string with, it's just an instrument with one string. Okay. And you use some sort of finger flip, okay, and then you play it with it. I automatically, like, I think everyone, not just me, automatically everyone understands, okay, this is something to do with Konkani region, like, you know, Maharashtra. So I really think that, you know, that's very valid to say that happens. So, yeah, you're right.
Wow, I'm really impressed, man. Okay, what's your dream, by the way? Come on, Susan, what's your dream?
I don't know yet. I just think that I want to be at a position where my music touches people's lives. So I'm just preparing for that. I'm trying sending my audios to different places and posting it on YouTube. As long as, you know, it touches someone and someone can relate to it, I think half of my purpose here is done. So that's what I think. Like, you know, it makes me happy. So I'm sure it's going to make a lot of other people happy as well.
I know. I mean, that is what it is. I feel it from deep inside. Till the time you're not happy, you won't be able to make others happy. And it depends how you make others happy. Like, for example, you do it with your music, with your instruments, with your voice. That's what we want. I mean, we want people in India, in this whole world, to spread happiness.
Yeah. That's
Believe me. And I really appreciate, because I said, okay, I am, you know, somewhat I like music too. So right now, there'll be a small, I should not say competition, but I want you to sing one song and I'll sing another song right now. So.
I don't mind. The only thing is my nose is blocked. So I'm going to sound.
Blocked in that case. You'll get 100 different errors.
Yeah. So like, I don't mind you singing. You can sing, it's fine. But I'm just, like, even I'm speaking from my nose, basically, like you can hear.
Okay, let me sing a song. Let me sing a song. Should I sing a song? Okay, Susan, where are you from?
Please.
Where are you from?
My dad is from Goa. My mom is from Mangalore, but I'm from Mumbai, born and brought up.
Wow, so you're like, you're Goan Mangi and you're from Mumbai. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, nice mixture. Let me sing a song, okay? So let me try it out. Please tell me where I'm going wrong, okay? So it's like, I haven't tried it that much. Mom is from Mangalore, and your dad is from Goa. Your nose is blocked right now. Thank you for coming to my show. I'm so happy. Oh my God, I'm so pathetic, man. Please. I have to learn a lot. So when are you teaching me? I know you're like, you're feeling inside. Oh my God, why? What did I hear? I have to use, you know, buds right now. It's okay. But you're not singing, man. What today do? I mean, today I actually told my viewers there'll be some music. So
there will. I can. So the thing is, it's unfortunate that my violin is gone for servicing.
Oh.
And my nose is blocked. The only thing I can play is my flute. So that's what I can do. So okay, if you don't mind, I can just, you know, improvise a little on my flute. And I can show a little of what I like playing in my free time.
Okay. I'll tell you one. I want to hear something from you. I mean, will you do that for me? You know, in those videos, the short, the comic videos, they put the flute that...
Oh, you mean like the coffin song?
Yeah, the coffin one. You're right. You got it right. Astronomia. The Astronomia is a song, right? Yeah, please.
I'm gonna try because I'm not tired on the flute, but like. Okay, so this is very abrupt. I'm gonna try my best. So
wow.
More than that, I can't because I'm just doing it by ear right now. This is very abrupt.
Okay, I've got a song for you. I don't know what kind of mood I am into today, but I want to actually sing. I'm really happy. I mean, you know, first of all, okay, definitely it's Diwali. After Corona, man, after a long time, we are actually, you know, opening up and talking to people. So, believe me, I usually keep, my talks very straight, though I do laugh, okay, but, you know, it's very educational. But today I'm not at all in a mood of that. Okay, believe me, I'm in a very chill out mood. And I really want to, you know, enjoy the music, and I'm really happy. I just like to say, Susan, I will definitely not sing a song right now. I just like to say that you're doing a great job. Follow your dream. I know dreams to follow, it's not that easy. I've been in theaters, and I know how hard it is to really stay focused, and you know. Stay in just 1 second.
Sure.
You know, to stay focused and, you know, stay in your profession, because I was a teacher, an English teacher before, and then I got into theaters and I got into acting and directing. You know what? Somewhere, okay, I tried to make sure I hold that rope of language because I was a linguist mentally. Exactly the way you have music, but, you know, because of that music, you have also gone into psychology. You happen to explain a lot of things which maybe, okay, was not in my head before. I also know one thing, that the reason why they play very slow music in malls is because they want people to walk slowly.
Yeah, so that they can walk slowly and they can look at, you know, not just do window shopping, but somehow be tempted to also shop it in real life, yeah.
True. So you guys are a part of our life, and we're not even aware that how you are pushing us at different places with your instrument without you saying that. And that's such a nice thing. And I'm really happy. I would just like to say that we'll definitely catch up somewhere, okay? And we'll have a concert once. So I want to see you in Sunburn soon. In future.
I don't think it's happening this year, but let's hope for the best.
Hope for the best. Thank you. Enjoy. I really had a great time with you, Susan. Bye.
Me too. You have a great day. Bye. Take care. That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast. That's the sound of the police.